How's it going, fellow agents? Vexy here. I hope you guys do your stretches, like what you do before cardio, because we're about to do a serious breakdown here. So do your stretches, crack your bones, and get ready for what I'm about to unveil to you. This is a Winter Soldier build, official assassin of the division. And I'd just like to put out that this is another build you can use in any game mode, guys. There's no limit to it. Now, before we start, please do subscribe if you haven't already. Hit the bell notification so you don't miss anything going forward. So guys, this is a crazy build, crazy sustain, a lot of ammo that's being available, the capacity is increased, and what more can I say? You'll be just literally swinging through all content just like this glitched rope in the background. Or even better yet, that you would have the enemy so scared that they'd rather fight themselves rather than fight you. You'd even have rogues second guessing and thinking, why did they even go rogue in the first place? Should have just stayed in the White House and not even come into the dark zone. Look at this. Wow. Exploded. Done. Biddy bye, sleep time. Anyway, guys, too much jokes. Let's get serious now. Let's get into the build. So guys, get ready. So the first piece would be the Brazos named one, which is called the Picard's holster. Second piece is my Brazos chest piece with the Talon Unbreakable, where I can roll it to any Talon I want. Then nextly will be the True Patriot. So you need three pieces of True Patriot. You can see a trend, so it's got the total armor and critical hit chance or damage on it, which is fantastic. And the backpack is the main piece for your build. So you've got the backpack that will give you extra set for your brand. Now, what's the amazing piece for your build is the talent measured on your gun. This is amazing because it basically gives you more weapon damage and actual rate of fire, as well as the actual damage itself when you do get to your half of your clip. And as you can imagine, the more you have on your expertise, the more damage you'll be doing. So as you can see, there's a lot of sort of multiplicative damage going on. As you can imagine, you're getting rate of fire from your gun, you're getting rate of fire as you can imagine from the vector as well, and you're getting rate of fire from the talent. So your gun will be going off crazy. Now, to top it off, my specialization is the gunner specialization. I'll be speaking about it in a moment. And on the actual tree, there is a part where it gives you 5% more rate of fire. So you can imagine how much rate of fire you'll be getting. I think in a game, this is the maximum I'd say you could get rate of fire wise on a build. Unless you specify into striker's build or a different variant. Now, this is another thing I wanted to show you guys as well. Now, this is for the minigun. Now, imagine you'd be thinking, okay, you know, this is a minigun, I don't really need to use it, but watch this. When you get your minigun out, that's right, you're getting more ammo capacity, you're getting your multiplicative damage. I'll just pause it here, and you can see that my actual health is going up as I'm hitting the chunga, the big guy, because I've got the free flags going on him, as well as I'm hitting. So as you could imagine, if you read the specifications in the green set, it says the more damage you do on the red, white and blue, they're doing less damage, they're taking more damage, and when you're hitting them, you're getting your armor back. So that's the amazing thing about it, guys. Do not sleep on this at all. So imagine your actual specialization is scaling with your ammo capacity and your actual ammo on your clip as well, which is amazing. So what I'd like to do next, guys, is quickly talk about the gunner specialization and show you exactly what I was talking about before and how it actually adds to your build. So The first thing I like most about it is the banshee. So, you know, if you feel like you're getting overwhelmed or rushed, you can kind of give yourself some seconds. But the barrage is the main thing I told you about before. So 5% on kill of rate of fire for 5 seconds. So as you can imagine, that's more rate of fire while you're shooting. So you can generate ammo as well when you're in the dark zone, which is amazing. And then lastly, what I really like the most is for every free reload, it's 50% faster. So with that said, when you're running around, you don't have to worry about reloading all the time. And, you know, your clip reloading or taking a long time. Now, I do personally feel that the measured talent is made for this build, I'll be perfectly honest with you. But you can use other talents. So, for example, you can use talents like Optimist, which makes and takes advantage of your ammo capacity, or any other talent that you feel that can work with your build. Now, the build itself is really, really robust. I mean, even some of your favorite guns and exotics, you can put those on as well, like maybe the Eagle Bearer. Another one that comes to mind is the Liberty pistol, possibly for more shots, or you can have the Lady Death. The Lady Death has got a very low clip capacity, and if you have that on, you could be shooting for longer and so on. So again, limitless builds and possibilities, guys. But wait, there's even more, guys. Now, with the build itself, again, this is just to do with damage. So I don't know if you guys are aware, but this is a brand set that probably has been forgotten about, the True Patriot. But what the main thing I do like the most about it is that it does a lot of things for you. So sustain reduces the damage from the enemy and they gain more damage, which is almost like having a Fox's Prayer on your build. But the main thing that I like the most is the fact that when you do get your stacks up, it helps you and it helps your teammate as well as reduce their damage and so on. But the creme de la creme is this, boom. Yeah, you see that? Boom. That basically does damage on both sides, guys. So that's damage when the explosion happens and it damages whoever's in and around that area. Now, the actual gear description says that once someone explodes, it only scales with their armor and their overall health. But this is reduced on actual bosses or named bosses itself. So as you can imagine, you know, it works in and around Dark Zone as well as the same as PvE content and PvP. So yeah, I mean, there's not really much more to say. This is a really great build. Just need to go ahead and check it out and take my word for it. I like to make videos on builds that you can use in almost all game modes, you know, because I do feel that there's a lot of builds that you can have, but I do prefer to have builds that are almost hybrid, where you can, you know, use them in any era. Because as you can imagine, the loot pool of Division is growing, guys. It is growing, and you have to be not just smart in what you hold in your gears, in your infantry, but just to maximize your slots for your saved builds, because I don't know about you guys, but I've actually almost run out of extra slots for my actual gear to save, you know, as a set or as an actual build. And yeah, so there you go. So that's probably the end of the video now, guys. I'll leave you some more footage of everything that I've shown you. So don't forget to hit the bell notification, subscribe, like, and comment. I will be doing a giveaway soon, so don't miss out. Subscribe and stay tuned. Now, there are some footage, guys, of me running around without my Winter Soldier outfit on. Don't be alarmed. That was just before I went through the Winter Soldier program, okay? But the build is still on and still, obviously, doing results. So yeah, but anyway, guys, this is Vexer signing out. Catch you guys in the next one. Peace.